More than 10% of people experience some kind of depression or a depression disorder, and often it's treated with medication. But as medical reporter Liz Bonus shows us, one local woman tried a unique approach, and it's put her on a journey to joy.
She was just 19 and in college the first time the depression hit.
And at that point in time, you know, didn't want to take any medication either. So I ran from that for 5 years.
By the time Stephanie Knox met her husband,
I hit my breaking point shortly after our wedding.
In the parking garage at work, Stephanie says she was paralyzed with sadness. She got out of her car to try and get cell phone reception and call for help.
And I was like crouched down in the corner behind a wall, and I was just sobbing.
That led to the discovery of Amanda Porter, a mental health counselor who treats patients from all over the country at the Lindner Center of Hope in Mason, Ohio.
This time, however, she made the decision she was going to take a different approach. It wasn't that she wasn't going to try medication, perhaps short-term or long, but this time she decided she would do some other things that could be done in her own home and with her therapist and beyond.
It's very common for someone to come to me and they know that they need help, but they don't want to be relying on medications for the rest of their life. You know, nobody wants to rely on a pill every day in order to be functioning and to be happy.
So the two of them began a unique approach to treating Stephanie's mental illness. She would taper off crisis medication and taper up steps to get better.
But there's a lot of things deeper down inside that have to be addressed.
And address them Stephanie did without adding more medication. She started with self-help. Things like reading, a drastic diet change to up her micronutrients, and a focus on getting more sleep.
Maintaining a regular sleep schedule is really important.
Stephanie then added everything from pet therapy,
which means I'm trying to take it, this month,
to float therapy, which uses salt water to soothe.
It takes about 2 or 3 minutes and you can feel the tension in your body just kind of go away.
Eventually, she added in exercise and a spiritual step that Porter recommends because she says for some people dealing with depression,
they don't know what their purpose is in life, they don't know what they're here on earth for, and I think that that spiritual component is really, really a vital piece of figuring all of that out, because none of those questions can be answered with a pill.
A year and a half later, Stephanie Knox says this journey to joy has worked, likely because
it gave me ownership over it, and it empowered me and kind of put me in the driver's seat. So that gave me my little glimmer of hope.
Liz Bonus, Local 12 News.
And you can find a link at local12.com for more information on this approach.